Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the English News from Djibouti Channel. We are the headlines of our news today. Arrived in Djibouti this morning. In continental news, Prime Minister Mark Rutte wins parliamentary elections in Netherlands. Welcome if you join us. The President of the Republic's Excellency, Mr. Ismail Omar Gele, sent today a message of condolence to his new counterpart of Tanzania, Mrs. Samia Suhulu Hassan, following the death yesterday of the president of this country, the late John Makufuli. In his message, President Gele expressed his compassion and solidarity with the brotherly Tanzanian people. The people and government of Djibouti join me in expressing their sympathy to the sister nation of Tanzania in the tragic ordeal of the passing of its enlightened leaders, he wrote. The death of President Makufuli is all the more painful of his compatriot, as he will never complete all the ambitious project he had for his country and his people. He then noted his emblematic achievement on governance and free schooling will remain the indelible marks of the extraordinary patriotism that was incurred on his in his body and soul. Continue. Tanzanian President John Makufuli died at the age of 61. The Republic of Djibouti received this morning, as I told in the title, a large quantity of vaccine doses against COVID-19, a total of 300,000 doses of vaccine Sinovac were received at Djibouti International Airport by members of the government, including the Minister of Foreign Affairs, Mr. Mahmoud Ali Youssef, as well as the Minister of Health, Mr. Mohamed Warsam Adiriya, the President of the Authority of Port and Free Zone, Mr. Aboubakar Omar Hadi, the Ambassador of China in Djibouti, Zuhu, and in the presence of the Secretary General of Health, Dr. Saleh Bonoita, and the Coordinator of the Agencies of United Nations, Barbara Manzi, the President of the National Commission of Vaccinations, Dr. Ahmed Roble, as well as the professional of the health. The first vaccines against the COVID-19 consist of 300 doses of COVAX vaccines from the Chinese company Sinovac, of which 200,000 doses were donated by the Chinese government and 100,000 doses were ordered by the Djiboutian government. The 300,000 doses of Sinovac vaccine were transported to Djibouti by plane, packed in refrigerated containers, and will be stored at Pika 13 in cold sheets adapted for the conservation until the vaccinations stage. The minister of, according to the Chinese ambassador to Djibouti, the arrival of these donations of vaccines in Djibouti is a perfect demonstration of the strong ties of friendship and brotherhood that united the two countries and the two peoples. The Minister of Health of Djibouti expressed his sincere thanks to the Chinese government and people for their consistent support to Djibouti's efforts in the fight against the pandemic, especially for through this donation of vaccine, which represents once again Chinese solidarity towards Djibouti. A strong delegation of Minister of Women and Family and the National Union of Djiboutian Women went on Tuesday to the region of Arta to proceed to the inaugurations of the Center Empowerment of Women in Arta. The delegation, led by the Minister of Women and Family, was received on arrival by the prefect of the region, the first deputy prefect, Mr. Mohamed Fouzi Ahmed, and the president of the regional council, Mr. Elmi Bouhou Goudadi. The minister of women was accompanied by this occasion by the secretary general of the union, UNFD, Mrs. Fatouma Moussa, the minister of social affairs, Mrs. Mona Osman Aden, as well as women parliamentarians from the region. The center, which aims to empower women in the region, is composed of several offices, namely the gender offices, the social assistance, and the UNFD offices. The delegation proceeded to the handover of materials to the community management committee, such as school bags, sewing machines, radios, and office materials. In addition, 10 of the most vulnerable women in the region each received the funding to create income generating activities. In her speech, the Secretary General of the National Union of Djibouti Women stressed the importance of the opening ceremony to the handing over of material to the community management and many other women in the region. Each has received funding to create their own businesses. In Dakhil in particular, where the Minister of Labour in charge of administrative reform, Mr. Osman Ibrahim Roble, accompanied by the Secretary General of the Secretariat of the State for Decentralization, Mr. Mohamed Issa Farage, proceeded in the presence of the Prefect of the region, Mr. Aden Darar Moussa, and the President of the Regional Council, Mr. Abdulrahman Yunis Arre, as well as the Regional Multi-Sectoral Committee to the handing over of the tools for the startup of the multi-services workshop to the service of the youth in the region. Colonel Wais Omar Bokore, commander of the Coast Guard, welcomed yesterday at Camp Dorale, the main facility of the Coast Guard, the strong Egyptian delegation led by Major General Hamdi, the Director General of the Aquatic Fishing Company of Egypt. The Egyptian delegation was introduced by the ambassador of the Republic of Djibouti in Egypt, Mr. Mohamed Duhur Hersi. Colonel Wais Omar Bokore welcomed the General Hamdi, the Director General of the Egyptian Aquatic Fishing Company, before making a brief presentation of the various mission of security and maritime safety facilities and equipment of the Djiboutian Coast Guard. During the meeting in the presence of the Ambassador of the Republic of Djibouti in Egypt, Mr. Mohamed Duhur Hersi, the General Manager of the Aquatic Fishing Company of Egypt, told Colonel Wais Omar Bokore, commander of the Coast Guard, his desire to invest in the marine landscape of our country. On Continent News, Mick Root welcomed a massive vote of confidence yesterday after 3 days of parliamentary elections dominated by the COVID-19 pandemic and from which his party emerged victorious. According to Excite polls, the Liberal Party of the outgoing Prime Minister came out on top in the election, which should allow him to lead his fourth government coalitions. Here we arrive at the end of this news edition. Thank you for watching us. Goodbye.